So, good morning, guys. This is Robbie here from Deep Focus, and today we are going to talk about a very important part of email marketing. So, most of you have heard of Mailchimp, I'm sure if you have ever done anything related to marketing, especially email marketing, Mailchimp is one of the best tools to send mass emails. And one of the things that if you are a Mailchimp user, you will have to deal with is verifying your domain with Mailchimp. So today's session is to give you an overview of how that can be done. So I'm logged into my Mailchimp account over here. And first of all, how do we start the verification process? On your left sidebar, you see this button website. When you click on this, and then on the navigation menu on the left, there is an option called domains. So this is where you can actually add your domain by clicking on add and verify, and you can enter your domain email address. So that would be, let's say if your domain is abc.com, you will enter the email address info@abc.com or any email that is related to abc.com, which you have access to, and you will get a verification code. Once you enter that, your domain's verification has started. The first step is over. Congratulations. So in this case, we are verifying the domain Divine Breath of Life, and we have done the first step of domain verification. Now the second step, as you can see, is authenticating the domain. So we are going to start with the authentication process. The first step is, let us start the authentication process. It will ask us what is our domain provider. Our domain provider is Hostinger. It is not mentioned here, so we will say others. Those of you who have domain, the most popular, of course, domain registration service is GoDaddy. So those of you who are on GoDaddy, you can just select GoDaddy. If you are using SiteGround, another popular, you can select, and so forth. But in this case, we have a domain provider, which is not mentioned in the dropdown, so we will mention others. The procedure is the same, so it doesn't really matter where your domain is registered, as long as you know the logins and you can access the DNS manager of your website. So wherever it is registered, the registrar provides you with a DNS manager area, and that's all you need to do this process. So first step is over. Now it's asking us to go to the domain name provider. We will log in, and after that, it will ask you to save these CNAME records in your DNS manager. So how do we do that? We go to our domain name provider's dashboard and let's log in. In this case, we have Hostinger. All right, guys. So there. Now we log into Hostinger, same password. So we have mpverma23@gmail.com. So we go into mpverma23@gmail.com. We enter the password and we log in, guys. All right. So we are in Hostinger now. All right, so you see here we have our domain divinebreathoflife.com. Now the next step, we need to do the authentication process. So we are going to click on our DNS manager by clicking manage. All right, now we are going to click on our DNS button over here, and there you see all of these records. Now I'd like to take a moment here to just talk briefly about what exactly is a DNS. So a lot of people, there's a lot of noise in the industry around what exactly is a DNS. And a DNS is basically a domain naming server. So when you have a website, I can actually create a registry of records of every domain. Once you register a name, it goes to ICANN for approval. The domain name is nothing but an address of your server's IP. The server IP, which is the universal resource locator, that is a 32-bit number, and it's very hard to remember those numbers, right? So it's something like 179.305.32.25. Can you remember that? But if I tell you to come to my domain, www.deepfocus.in, it'll be very easy for you to remember. So what the DNS manager does really is, essentially, it connects the IP with the domain name. So in this case, what do we want to connect? We want to connect the MailChimp's IP addresses with your domain name. So this is exactly why we are in the domain naming server. But you can see a domain deals with so many other things, your email, your server, your subdomains. It could be your email server provider. So all of these details. So you can see, if you can see my screen, you'll be seeing the different details about the domain. Like this is the IP, FTP. This is the for the PHP hosting. This is for the individual mails, you know, the corporate mail account and so forth. So we are going to now follow the next step of creating the domain name manager record. Now, what does it say over here? Let's go back to MailChimp. And we see over here the two types of records that we need to add, CNAME1 and CNAME2. So what is CNAME? CNAME is a type of record. How many types of records there are? There is a TXT record. There is a CNAME record. There is a very important record. The most important record is the A record. The A record will always be the record of the master domain. So, for example, if you look at the DNS records over here, the master record right over here is the A record. This actually tells the master IP address of that domain. So these are the various records. For example, if you check your email on Outlook, but your domain is on GoDaddy, what will you do? You will use the MX type record. MX records are for mail servers. In this case, we are not setting up a mail server. Always remember, we are not setting up a mail server. MailChimp does the heavy lifting of delivering your mails. We are just adding a signature. We are adding a record in our domain for the MailChimp signature, right? So what we are going to do, we are going to create a CNAME, not an A record, not an MX, but a CNAME. So we're going to copy this value by clicking copy, very simple. So as you can see, this is a very simple process. No coding is involved. There's a lot of noise around this and a lot of people say, oh, you know, how to do this, how to do that. But it's actually a very simple trick. So we copy the record values. Now, first of all, what record we have to create? CNAME. So we click on CNAME. Then we add name. And then we add our target value. Copy this value and we put it in a target. Now notice something, that there is a value called TTL. So those of you who are doing this for the first time, TTL is nothing but time to live. What does this mean? The time to live is a unit of measurement of how long a request will remain in the cyberspace. So a TTL of 14,400, always remember the unit of measurement is milliseconds, not seconds, milliseconds. So for 14,400 milliseconds, this signature is going to reflect on every request. So if I want to request, what is my signature or what are my CNAME records, my request will stay for that designated time period. So in order to make the delivery faster, it is better to have lower time to live. So we are going to go back to MailChimp and see what is the value that they recommend. And you can see that they say, if you have an option for TTL, either leave it at the default setting or choose the lowest value offered. So let's see if there is a lowest value offered. There isn't actually. And you see the default setting is 1400. So we are going to keep it at 1400. But it looks like the lowest value, now this is where you have to do a little bit of analysis, is 300. So we can try and set up a TTL value of 300 milliseconds. That is very fast. All right, so we are going to save this. Wonderful. So we have added our CNAME record. Let us verify that our CNAME record is there. Let's click on edit and make sure that our values are saved. Wonderful. Now we are going to go back and create our CNAME 2. We will copy the records, add the value, choose CNAME. Copy this value, paste it here, copy this value, paste it here, again TTL values will be 300, and we add the record, guys. So let's see, I hope you can see my screen, and there we go. So the value should be added. Let's just verify. So k2.domainkey and k3.domainkey, two values have been added. K2 is pointing to DKIM2 and K3 is pointing to DKIM3. In my next blog, I will explain you what is DKIMs and how do they actually internally affect your delivery. But I think for now, this should do the job. So let us proceed further. So if this process has been done correctly, your DNS will propagate this new value in few minutes. It does take a few minutes, but with evolving times, sometimes it is very, very fast and instant. So let's try and see if our domain has been authenticated. And it says done. Now it says check the status. So let's, all right, fingers crossed, guys. Your records haven't been validated. It says enjoy a cup of coffee. So it does take a few minutes. So we are going to wait for a few minutes and see. We're going to get back and see when our domain gets authenticated. Meantime, we are going to actually start our next domain. Breath of life has been done. All right, guys. And our next domain is jumpingintosourcebliss.com, right? So same procedure we are going to do with jumpingintosourcebliss.com, but hold on a second. Let's see what is the sending domain. Always remember that the verification, it only matters for the domain which is sending your email. So in this case, the domain is Divine Breath of Life and we have done the integration. So let us wait and watch how long it takes for our domain to get verified. We are going to again try. Let's click on check status. And it is taking time this time. Bad news. So we still haven't done. So what could be wrong? Is it genuinely taking time or have we done the job correctly? How do we know that? What is the best way to verify the CNAME values? There is a tool called MX Toolbox, which will help us to look up and verify that what we have done just now, has it taken effect or not? So what we are going to do, we are going to this tool now, MX Toolbox. Okay, guys, so we are going to go to MX Toolbox. And in the MX Toolbox, now what we are going to do is we are going to add our domain. Right? And going to add our domain and do an MX lookup. So you see over here that it is telling me about my host name. If you can see my screen. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select CNAME value. Let's see, we do have a CNAME. Correct. So on your drop down, select the CNAME lookup and click CNAME just to see that the values are propagating or not. So it says DNS records published, DNS records not found. CNAME, MX records. So it looks like we might be looking into, we need to have little bit of further research into this topic. Let us ensure that our values have been saved. How do we do that? We are going to go back to our dashboard and then click manage and then click DNS and then check whether our values are saved. So k3.domainkey and this and the content and the TTL all is saved properly. So guys, it looks like our values have been saved correctly and it is just a matter of time till it actually propagates the values. So let us wait for a few minutes more and see if our domain gets authenticated or not. All right, guys, I'm going to get back on the video and give you an update on how this authentication went through. Thank you, guys.